Today Sports welcomes you to the following presentation of the NBA.
And those are the starting lineups, so kick back, get your popcorn ready. We'll be back in just a moment. Good afternoon, and welcome to a midday edition of the NBA on 2K Sports. Hope you're enjoying the weekend so far. With Hall of Famers Grant Hill and Doris Burke, this is Brian Anderson. Joining us from the sidelines, Allie LaForce. Allie, it's all yours.
Anthony Edwards is on the rise. Karl Anthony Towns said, quote, he already has the talent. We all knew that when we drafted him. But he just wants it. And he has that thing, something you can't teach. It has to be built in. Asked of a ceiling, Edwards says, quote, I don't think I have one. I can be as good as anyone. Brian?
Oh, tremendous, Allie. Thank you. You know, Grant, a positive trend in this league right now. Teams would rather risk losing a game than sacrifice a player's health.
Well, it's all about a player's health, BA, when it's all said and done. A player with minor injuries are usually held out now, sometimes even against their own will. A much different situation than when I was playing many years ago.
And a look at Minnesota's opening lineup. Filling in the wings, Edwards and McDaniels. Karl Anthony Towns is out there with Naz Reid, and it's Conley in at the point guard position. And for the Spurs, at the two and the three, it's Vassell and Johnson. Then there's Zach Collins, and it's Jones in at the point guard position. Now here's Vassell, a dependable player on offense, giving them over 13 a game. Six to shoot. Spurs need to get one up here. Jones. Towns with a rebound. Edwards against Vassell. Basket counts.
Boy, the quickness off the dribble drive by Anthony Edwards. Being able to put it on the deck, so important.
Outside Johnson. Back to Jones. To the paint. Here's Vassell. And he takes the fantastic lead pass up strong for the slam.
Just great offense. The screen freeing him up for the slam.
Hey, without that screen, he doesn't get a clean look at the rim.
Boy, that's a play you just practice time and time again, and that's the result of the work put in.
The kick out to Edwards. Oh, and he just knocked down the buzzer beater.
What a huge shot to beat the buzzer. My goodness.
Well, that's the perfect end of the quarter for them. You have no idea how much of an effect those buzzer beaters can have on a team's momentum.
So, at the end of one quarter of play, still a close game. The T-Wolves on top. They lead by three. And the second quarter is on its way when we return.
Spurs fans, get loud for
you. Man, it's been a pretty even game here after one quarter of play. All right, let's quickly break down the game. What we've seen so far from the Timberwolves, guys.
Well, their offense is clicking so far, capturing the momentum here early on.
Boy, it's been a really pretty thing to watch, executing their game plan to perfection.
Johnson is out there with Kata Bates-Diop. Then there's Devontae Graham. And it's Bassey in at the center position, locking down the middle. That's the San Antonio Five. Pass to Alexander Walker. Now here's Towns. He's closely guarded. Just three to shoot. Launches a three. Bassey pulls it in. Outside Graham. There's 25 seconds left in the first half of this one. Let's it go. The Spurs rebound. Outside Johnson. The three-pointer off the mark. Here's Alexander Walker. Released it in time, but it's off the mark. And the first half comes to a conclusion in a game that's been very close so far. The T-Wolves on top. They lead by three. And join us right back here after the break for the start of the second half.
And now, the 2K Sports Halftime Show. Hey, everybody. Good to see you back here on our halftime show. Well, actually, we can't see you, but you can see us. But you get it. Ernie Johnson, Kenny the Jet Smith, Shaquille O'Neal. You're watching the NBA on 2K Sports. It was a closely contested first quarter for Minnesota. The period came to a close with them holding a three-point lead. Scoring-wise, they broke even in the second, so little ground was lost there. And, Kenny, what did you see out there from the Timberwolves?
They're running a smooth offense tonight, creating high-quality shots. Motion, sharp. Sharp as a razor. Their spacing is excellent. They're moving the ball well. I love the way they're doing.
Shaq, what's your take on San Antonio so far?
Well, they're just not creating enough scoring opportunities, and they're pretty lucky they're not trailing by 15 right now. They need to play more unselfishly, work for better spacing, go stronger to the basket.
And that'll do it for us. The third quarter about to begin with Kevin Harlan standing by. We'll catch you on the flip side.
My brother.
And in that first half, we saw a pretty tight battle. We'll soon find out what sort of adjustments were discussed during halftime. Boy, you gotta like what we're seeing from Anthony Edwards.
Yeah, even with the extra attention he's getting from the defenders, he's finding ways to excel.
Well, he knows they're coming for him, but he's accustomed to that kind of attention, and he's quite comfortable dealing with it.
And after a fairly even first couple of quarters, this second half could turn out to be a great one, as both teams trying to gain an edge. Kicking off the second half, here's Chris Finch's five. Filling in the wings, Edwards and McDaniels. Nas Reed out there with Carl Anthony Towns. And it's Conley in at the one spot. Now here's Towns. An effective score for them, scoring around 21 and a half points a game. And he was fouled while in the act of shooting, so he'll take two free throws. Well, the Timberwolves struck gold by getting the number one pick in the 2015 and 2020 NBA drafts.
You were so right, BA, selecting Carl Anthony Towns and Anthony Edwards, respectively. Two important players that have already had a tremendous impact on this team.
Take a break. Take a break.
First free throw is good.
And we've seen the Spurs part ways with some of their best veterans. It really speaks to the talent at the top of the 2023 NBA draft. Savvy organizations like San Antonio will time their rebuilds to the years when the draft boasts some of those elite prospects.
Jang, he's checked in for San Antonio. That one's no good. And you'd like to go two for one here, Grant.
And at the same time, you want to get a good shot here, BA.
From 7 feet. Ooh, and he took a hard foul on the shot. So he'll head to the line to shoot a pair.
Man, he made sure to get his money's worth on that foul.
At the line for your Spurs, Devin Vassell. Two shots.
Down the first one.
And in trading for Rudy Gobert, the Timberwolves taking a Twin Towers approach with 2 7-footers in their front court. Of course, the outstanding shooting of Carl Anthony Towns means that spacing shouldn't be much of a concern.
The Timberwolves making a switch here. Prince has checked in. And that's good as he hits both shots.
Well, this is why you run your offense through him in important situations. You know he's going to deliver.
Outside Edwards. Pass to McDaniels. Rebound San Antonio. Top of the cell. Over Edwards. No good. Misses at
at the buzzer. Three quarters of play and a close one here. The T-Wolves on top. They're up by two. And we'll have the start of the fourth quarter for you as soon as we get back from this short break. And a moment now as we take a look at our State Farm assist of the game.
And he definitely deserves the award. Reading the defense like a point guard.
He's got the size to survey over the top of the defense and find the open man. That was beautiful.
Well, what a terrific game it's been so far, with this fourth quarter sure to bring more pressure-packed basketball. At the two and the three, it's Vassell and Johnson. Then there's Kim Birch, and it's Jones in at the one. That's who's in the game for the Spurs. Anderson against Johnson. Here's Towns. And he buries it.
Great to see guys who don't back down under pressure.
To me, more often than not, when you attack, good things happen.
And the Spurs call time here. Trailing by four. 41 seconds left in the final quarter.
Plays because we know they're going to. Back to you.
Thanks for that, Allie.
Great timing and coordination. Lays it in coming off that pick.
Expect them to take their time this trip down.
Yeah, BA. The clock is theirs to burn.
They grab their own miss. Oh, he nails it.
Timeout. Love his tenacity. Extra possessions, second chance points. That's winning basketball.
Time called here. San Antonio decides to talk it over. They're trailing by four. 26 seconds left to play in the fourth quarter.
Doesn't matter who's guarding him. He's had an answer for just about everyone.
Collins, he's checked in for San Antonio. Graham comes in for Jones. 2 seconds separating the shot clock and the game clock. Misses the jumper from the wing. And they commit an intentional foul. We'll see another one of those, so they get into the penalty.
Yeah, just trying to keep this game alive. Not a bad foul right there.
And Minnesota calls time here. They're up by four. There's 14 seconds left in the fourth quarter. That's an intentional foul.
Keldon Johnson. Second personal foul. Second team foul. At the line for the Timberwolves.
Oh, take,
Mike
a break.
Conley
take a break.
Taking two shots.
And he misses the first one. Boy, he wanted that one to go.
Well, here's a guy with a great deal of experience in these situations. Mike Conley's team very confident with his chance to deliver at the foul line.
And he ends up making the second. And that puts him up five. We've got 13 seconds left in the fourth. From deep, Johnson. Rebounded by the Timberwolves. And they go to the intentional foul.
Devontae Graham, second personal foul, third team foul. At the line for the Timberwolves, Mike Conley at the line for two.
Take a break, take a break. Two shots.
So the first one drops. And that increases the lead to six.
Well, the seasoned veteran Mike Conley has been such a soft-spoken guy, but he has also been one of the NBA's best leaders both on and off the floor.
And he hits both free throws here, and it's a seven-point game. Graham with it. The three is up. Offline. So we see the Timberwolves get the win here. This was a hard-fought, well-earned victory for them. They had to dig deep to come out on top.
Yeah, you know, some teams might buckle under the pressure towards the end. The crowd was so amped up, such a hostile environment. But they stood tall and got the win.
Well, now a minute to check in with Allie LaForce. She's courtside. Hey, Allie.
All right, I'm with Carl Anthony Towns. Carl, congratulations on the victory. What was key in getting the win here tonight?
We played like we wanted it more. You know, we came out here and we just did a lot of great defensive stops. It wasn't offensive. It was more defensive. We did a great job. We got those 50-50 balls, put us in a nice position.
We could see and feel that desperation. Congrats on the win.
Allie, thank you as always. And that'll wrap it up, folks. For Doris Burke, Allie LaForce, and Grant Hill, and all of our crew, this is Brian Anderson thanking you for watching this 2K Sports presentation of the NBA. We'll see you next time.